Hi and welcome to this Dreamweaver tutorial. My name is Daniel Walter Scott and I am a trainer here at Bring Your Own Laptop. And this course is designed for people that have never used Dreamweaver before or are new to web design. And the topic we're covering in this session is how to define a website. Okay, so this is the first step when it comes to creating your website in Dreamweaver. What happens is in a website, you need to have all of your elements of the website in one folder. Unlike some other professions like graphic design, where you get to have images and text and logos all over your hard drive. Okay, to design a website, you need to keep everything in the same folder. They call it your local folder. Okay. And what you need to do is tell Dreamweaver using its site function. Okay, you define its site and tell it where this local site folder is kept. Okay, so let's do that together now. So the first thing we're going to do is go up to Site, okay, and go to New Site. You'll need a new site definition for every new website you're working on. If you're working on only one website, you've got one website to create or update. You'll only have to do this once. Me, as a freelance web designer, I have lots of these sites defined all over my hard drive in different places. Okay, so we give the site a name. I'm going to call this one Example Tutorial. Okay, this is where you give it a name, the client name or the job description, something like that, and useful for you to describe it, different from other websites on your Dreamweaver. This, where it says local site folder, this is where on your hard drive your website's going to be kept. So for me, I'm going to click on browse folder. I'm using a Mac. It doesn't matter whether you're using a PC or a Mac. And I'm going to put a new folder on my desktop. Okay, you might keep yours in your documents. I'm going to call this example tutorial and click create, then click choose. So I've told it its site name, which is example tutorial. Okay, and I have given it, I've told it where I'm going to keep this website. So every file that I need to design now needs to go inside this folder. Last thing I need to do is look at the advanced settings. Click on the word advanced settings. If that doesn't work, click on the word local info. And you should get this right hand side looking like mine. Last thing we need to do is tell Dreamweaver where we'd like to keep our default folders, our default images folder. So to do that, let's click on browse. Now you could keep all your images in your just the place that we decided before, which is called the example tutorial folder, but it's very common to have a subfolder in your website. And it's either called images, or some people like to call it IMG. It's up to you. Okay, it should be used as a lowercase. Okay, so it should be a lowercase I. And whatever you name it, make sure that you use the naming convention that has no spaces. Okay, so don't have a space included in that list. Okay, see here. Don't use things like ampersands or asterisks or hash symbols or question marks. These can all throw up problems with your website. So make sure if you do decide to have a space, okay, use a hyphen instead. You could use an underscore, but a hyphen is more commonly used. Okay, so I'm just going to call my folder images with a lowercase I, click create. Okay, and I'm going to click choose. So I've told it in the site one at the top here, the name. I've told it where on my hard drive it's going to be kept. And under advanced settings local info, I've told it where the images are going to be stored for my website. And that's all we need to do now. All right, see you in the next tutorial.